It's Sunday morning and I've made my way to one of my favorite displays here at the show, and he's hard at work. He has 437 now in the corporate paint and NECR 2048 as well. VTR 209, 313, seen both of those. MEC 507, I've seen that one. All these down here, smaller engines, Naugatuck, EARY, Eastern Alabama. These must be in East Deerfield or something. Bat and Kill ones, of course, I've seen. New Brunswick Southern, a railroad I need to get out and shoot. More Bat and Kill. He has Hal's new, not new, but new to Hal, RS1. And then, of course, Hal's pair of Alco switchers. Fictional Berkshire and Eastern Dash 8. One of the Berkshire and Eastern patches. This one hasn't even seen service on the road yet. Some RDCs, CT Rail stuff, MBTA, the Conway F units, New Hampshire North Coast 1801, Pioneer Valley, the short line here in Westfield that I really need to shoot. GATX, maybe that's a Housatonic reference. Midcoast Rail Service, shot that. St. Lawrence and Atlantic, the new Mac. That only just came in probably a month ago. Housatonic 22, CP Eco unit, those are great looking. The new Mass Central Dash 8, formerly Saratoga and North Creek. Mass Central GP9, I guess. Main switching services, I believe, that locomotive is on. Mass Coastal, another railroad I haven't shot yet. And some more smaller stuff. I think that's Hobo Railroad, and then some more critters. Overall, a beautiful display of lots of locomotives I've seen and some more that I want to.
Where's the Jivos?
Gee.
Small enough for you?
No Gevos.
No Gevo, but is it small enough for you?
I've seen smaller.
Well, there's Model Railroad. I need that. I really, really need that. But do I need it bad enough that I spend $100 on it? I don't know. So I found something I really want, which is the D&H breast cancer gondola. I really want the Pan Am, but it's a four pack and I really don't need four of them. It's $100. If it was 25 for one, I would buy it, but I really don't need four, but we're gonna get this, definitely. Record year for the show, he just announced it. And of course you have Narcoa, Speeder Car Club. They're a really great group. I always enjoy seeing them out on the rails. Hope to do more with them in the future as far as video. And of course you have the SCNH in Corinth, New York. Mini Prince doing a scan. This is something the hobby has never seen before. Until about 2 years ago. It's quite the process. It's really cool to see. I've been following Mini Prince since before Mini Prince was even around. Back when it was just his blog on WordPress. It's very wet snow. That's probably melting the moment it hits the ground. Got the S gauge, or S scale, I suppose, technically, group here. D&H PA is pulling freight.
Thank you.
back at one of my favorite layouts, Dry Hill. I've got some NECR out in the yard, along with Owen's VTR stuff. Casual four-way meet.
When they're working, these brushes come up automatically when it goes over a sensor, right?
Thank you.
Smoking exhaust diesels, but it's G-scale. I'm pretty sure these cars are 3D printed. They have the lines that would indicate they're 3D printed. This train is quite long. The Genesee in Wyoming haunts me even when I'm not in North America. I'll say it right now. I hate Genesee in Wyoming. That's a good looking steamer though. Pan Am OCS sitting here, along with some other Northeast cars. NEC 604, the classic SD40s that are sadly now all gone.
How you doing?
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, that's why I'm sure.
You tried. But you should have got the exact one.
David. This is O-scale narrow gauge, which I think is a pretty cool scale. It uses HO gauge track. But you can do more at a larger scale with narrow gauge. ON30, that's what it is.
to be indoors.
What was that?
It's always good to be indoors.
We got the P&W SD70 M-2 in the correct paint scheme. I hate G&W, and I will stand by that statement. Walking around the Better Living Center for probably the last time. I'm tired. I want to see some things on the way home. I don't know why the camera's so blurry. But yeah, about done here. But it's been a great show.